I believe that the statement made by Prime Minister Netanyahu would be based on some kind of intelligence that, from the Israeli perspective, is credible. Prime Minister Netanyahu is not exactly accurate at all times, and sometimes he has a tendency to exaggerate the danger, to exaggerate any given situation. But the truth is based on intelligence even that received by the United States. Iran is moving fairly quickly to acquire the technology to produce nuclear weapon and to enrich sufficient uranium to that end. I do not necessarily agree that this is going to be to take necessarily 6 months or 5 months or 7 months. This is something to be seen. As to the statement of Martin Indyk, well, you have to be a prophet in a way to make the suggestion that the United States will attack Iran in March or April of next year. I think several things will have to take place before that. A determination that Iran actually has moved very closely to acquiring the technology to assemble a nuclear weapon very quickly, that it has already enriched sufficient uranium to that end, that the sanctions absolutely fail and there's no chance for the sanction to work any further. The diplomacy has reached a dead end. And so you have to have all of these components put together for the United States to finally decide that the only option that left will be a military action against Iran. But that is really the problem here. Who is going to make that ultimate judgment as to whether all of these four components have actually been put together to warrant an American attack on Iran nuclear facilities. This is something that we have to see how that might evolve. The one thing that I think I would like to suggest is that, needless to say, that following the presidential election, Obama may be freer, of course, to take action against Iran. But if Romney happened to win, will he attack sooner than later? We cannot say what might happen. So the result of the presidential election will have serious bearing as to what to do with Iran once the election are over. Well, you can expect Iran to do whatever it can to instigate Hezbollah, to instigate Hamas, to provoke other countries in the region, in the Gulf. Iran will do whatever it can in order to undermine the United States, as well as to undermine Israel, if not directly threaten Israel. But I think we also have to think in terms of what the Iranians are thinking for themselves, in terms of they can do some of that. What will be the repercussion? Will Hezbollah be actually prepared to take such action, knowing full well that Israel might respond in a manner that could destroy half of Lebanon? Will Hamas actually move quickly to do something, to take action against Israel? If the Muslim Brotherhood in Egypt, the government in Egypt, tells them under no circumstances they should participate in such activities, such military action. These are unknown. Even Iran, does any really one know in which manner Iran will in fact react? From Israeli intelligence suggests that Iran might do very little, might just go to the United Nations and protest, because ultimately the Iranian government wants to stay in power. And that's going to be first and foremost. If retaliating is conceivably could undermine the regime, they may not retaliate in the manner that many people speculate.